No, not really, sir. So I'm born a Hindu and I die a Hindu.
Born a Hindu, brother, even I was born a Hindu. I don't know that I am Hindu. You know what the definition of the word Hindu? Hindu by definition means a person who lives in the land of Indus Valley. The people who live in India are called as Hindus.
Correct.
This word Hindu is not there in any of the religious scriptures. It was first used by the Arabs. When the Arabs came to India, they gave the word Hindi. Hindi hai. You know, when I go to Saudi and here they call me Hindi. Hindi means a person Hindu. Coming from India. Hindu. It is not a religion. So you are a Hindu, I am a Hindu geographically. Hindu is not a religious definition at all. According to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, if you read his book, Discover of India, he writes, the word Hindu doesn't exist in any of the Hindu scriptures before the advent of the Arabs to India. So Hindu is a geographical definition, brother. Even I am a Hindu. I come from India. And the Arabs call me Hindi, Hindi. Hindi doesn't mean idol worshipper. Hindi means coming from India. So I know you're a Hindu. I'm talking about a religious belief. If your religious belief, do you believe in one God?
Well, sir, I know where we're going, but I'm a very strong believer of the fact.
No, I don't. I'm
saying a statement would
not
change.
No, I'm not telling you, brother. I'm not telling you to change your religion.
Put me in a mosque.
I'm not telling you to change your religion. If I ask you, do you believe in God? You said yes. If I say, do you believe in ideals? You may say no, then I'll correct you.
Okay. So your question is, do you believe in one God?
Do you believe in one God?
No. I believe in a lot of gods.
Okay,
we have
fine.
33 crore
very
gods.
Good, very good. Now I want to help you. Don't become a Muslim. But I want to help you. Because you are not a Muslim, I want to help you more. Now you said you believe in 33 crore gods. Where you got this from? The Hindu scriptures, correct? Now if you read Chandogya...
I just heard about it, sir.
From
to be
where?
Very honest,
oh, so you believe...
Cited.
Oh, mashallah. So you believe in anything what you hear? Why don't you believe in what you hear from me?
Well, sir,
am I your enemy, brother? I love you, brother. Well, sir, I love you.
Where I come from, it's not that I've just heard it from one person the way you said it, but yeah, I've heard it from my parents, my uncles, and probably 1.2 billion people in India believe
fine.
Exactly the way I believe.
Fine.
So it's not
I
that all of us are doing something wrong.
I'll correct you.
There's something
you.
Which we are doing right, which is common between
I disagree.
Us, which I believe is Hinduism.
I disagree that 1.2 billion believe. I do agree majority of the Hindus believe, not all. I know many Hindus who disagree with what you have said. Because those who have read the Hindu scriptures, where you get this from? From the scriptures.
Correct.
Anyone says from the mind, if your father tomorrow says 2 plus 2 is equal to 5, will you believe? If your father says 2 plus 2 is equal to 5, will you believe?
Well, not unless somebody corrects me.
No, if your father tells you today, 2 okay. plus 2 is equal to 5,
no,
will you believe?
I will not believe.
MashaAllah, you're an educated man, therefore you won't believe, correct?
Correct.
Now, I'm giving you reference from your scriptures.
Okay.
And you have to ask your father, in Hindu scriptures, as I mentioned earlier, there are two types of scriptures. One is Shruti, one is Smriti. Shruti means the word of God. Vedas, Upanishads. Next comes Smriti, the Puranas, the Itihas, Ramayan, Mahabharat. If you read Upanishad, the most superior, it's mentioned in Chandogya Upanishad, chapter number 6, section number 2, verse number 1. Ikkam Evidityam. God is only one without a second. It's a Sanskrit quotation, brother. Ikkam Evidityam. God is only one without a second. It's mentioned in the Sweta Setar Upanishad, chapter number 6, verse number 9. Nakasya Kasij, Janitana Chadipa. Of that God, there is no superior. There are no parents. It's mentioned in Sweta Setar Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19. Na tasya pratima asti. Of that God, there is no image. Pratima in Sanskrit means an image, a photograph, a painting, a picture, a sculpture, a statue. Sweta Setar Upanishad, chapter number 4, verse number 19 says, Na tasya pratima asti. Of that God, there are no images, no photographs, no paintings, no pictures, no statues, no idols. If you read the Vedas, I'm talking about the higher scriptures, I'm not talking about lower scriptures. I'm talking about Shrutis. Shrutis consist of Upanishads and Vedas. It's mentioned in Yajurved, chapter number 32, verse number 3, Natasya Pratima Asti. Of that God, there is no Pratima. Of that God, there are no images, there are no photographs, there are no paintings, there are no pictures, there are no idols, there are no statues. You will tell me, I know where you're taking me. I'm not taking you anywhere, I'm taking you to your scriptures. I'm taking you to your scriptures. Fine? That's a different thing. Your scriptures match with the Quran. What can I do? Furthermore, brother, if you read Yajurveda chapter number 40, verse number 9, it says, Andhatmipa Vishanti Ya Asambhuti Mupaste. They are entering darkness, those who worship the Asambhuti. Asambhuti are natural things like fire, water, air, etc. Who said that? Yajurveda. And the verse continues, they are entering more in darkness, those who worship the Sambhuti. Sambhuti are the created things like table, chair, car, idols, etc. Who says that? Yajurveda chapter number 40, verse number 9. Now, when your father told you about 33 crore gods, I don't know whether he gave you references or not. I'm giving you references. You can take my references, note it down, take the video cassette, go and ask your father. Go and ask your pandit. I'm not telling you to believe me blindly, brother. You believed your father blindly. You did a mistake once. Don't do the mistake the second time. If you know where I'm taking you, I'm not in a hurry. I want you to be a firm believer, not just because my father said. So tomorrow you can quote the scripture. Fine. Now, if you are a Hindu, true Hindu, you should follow the scriptures. Like the sister that came earlier, she asked me question once, she asked me twice, she asked me third time, she got convinced. You don't get convinced, no problem. You take time. She got convinced with three questions. I'm not forcing you. It's not allowed in Islam. I'm only giving you guidance.
I cannot give it
unless Almighty God puts it in your heart. So if you want to search the truthfulness in Almighty God, all these references you can go and check up. Go and ask your father, go and ask your pandit. I want not you, I want your father to come along with you, inshallah. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you very much for all the information, sir. May God bless you.